What is the most uncomfortable, unpleasant way you've ever realized someone had a crush on you? A girl I knew back in high school was a notorious stalker. My friend circle tended to be the main targets of this stalking. She obviously got all her ideas of romance from teen romance novels and TV shows because she would bombard these guys with songs, poetry, and straight up professions of love. She was even the type to count the curls in a guy's hair when sitting in class. She once sent my best friend an email asking about an assignment with some hidden white text that read, "I am a brown dragon, and you are my rider." Also sent a 3-page threat letter to a girl who went to homecoming with another friend. Fast forward a few years, I was engaged and somehow stalker gal is too. We're both about 20 and she sends me a message on Facebook saying, "You know, you were one of the only one of your friends that I never tried to pursue, and I regret it every day." I responded, "What?" She then unfriended and blocked me. Best of luck to that psycho. Recently, a girl I knew from school broke up with her boyfriend. She got really drunk and started flirting with me through text. When I didn't respond accordingly, I stopped hearing from her. Then she showed up at my apartment and said, "Do you like that? So you like when I flirt with you like that? One step above you like that, you freaking retard?" "You freaking retard" is my favorite pickup line. Works every time. I was in my second year of uni and lived in the dorms. It was right around Halloween. The guy was someone I'd met at my quad's Halloween party. We talked a little, but I spent most of my time talking to friends, a lot of it making plans for where we were going to go for our after party. Guy and I made plans to meet up in a few days for lunch. Over the next few days, I keep finding notes on my door. Nothing too bad, but just enough to weird me out. Stuff like, "You have a beautiful laugh," when normally the notes people left on my door were more along the lines of, "Grabbed X from the C store for you, or can I borrow your mixing bowls?" I was one of the few people in my building with some cooking supplies since my stress relief is baking. Anyways, I came down with this nasty stomach bug, puking my guts out and trying not to turn into a diarrhea fountain. It hit the night before the lunch meeting with the guy and lasted about 36 hours. Sent the guy a message saying I was sick and could we reschedule for another time, maybe on the weekend. Never got a response, but a few hours later, I heard a knock on my door. The guy proceeded to sit outside my door for several hours, trying to get me to let him in. The first 20-ish minutes or so, it seemed sweet, but when I left at one point to run to the bathroom, it didn't end up being nearly so sweet. He went into my room and was making himself comfy in my bed. When I came back, he held his arms out and said he'd make everything better. Yeah, no. Got my Ra's boyfriend, who lived in her room with her, to help get the guy out. Guy stayed away for about an hour, aka until the Ra's boyfriend left for work, and spent the next several hours just sitting outside my room, blocking the doorway and leaving me feeling trapped in my room. Eventually he left. I felt so nervous going in and out of my room for a couple of weeks afterwards though. Quad staff uni police were not at all helpful. My Ra and her BF had my back and I was on good terms with a lot of the guys in my building. 3/4 of building was male, which is what ended helping me the most. Ra and BF kept an eye on my room and my Ra would text me if she saw the creeper on our floor. My guy friends had the same similar classes as me, so I always had at least one person who was willing to walk with me on campus near our quad, and we usually went to lunch supper in groups of 3+. Still, it took until about Valentine's Day for the creeper to finally leave me alone. Shoulder puked on him. I've had a few. I seem to be a weirdo magnet. One I haven't talked about much, if at all, on here is a girl I knew as an undergrad. I wouldn't say we were friends, but we knew each other from various campus groups. There's a restaurant near campus that does cheap decent sushi from like 11 PM to 1 AM. And one night she texted me asking if I wanted to go with her and some other acquaintances and friends. I said sure, but when I showed up, she was the only one there. She stated that everyone else, supposedly, like 5 other people were coming, couldn't make it. Cue one of the most awkward 40-ish minutes of my life. Given, she has Asperger's, so maybe that's why she thought it was a good idea. I'm in first year of undergrad and think she might not have been lying. Just the other week we were supposed to go out with 10 people and only 4 people showed up. You don't really know who is or isn't flaky until you've known them for a while. Me and my brother are reminiscing about high school times. Brother asks me if I remember this one girl. him like, yeah, vaguely know who she is, but never spoke to her. Brother mentions that this girl was obsessed with me, like asked my brother constantly what I did that day, started actually losing weight hoping I would notice her in some way, kept taking photos of me, asked my brother what kind of girls I am into. I had absolutely no idea at all. To me, she was just someone I knew of that sometimes hung out in the same group my brother did. Kinda weird he never said anything to you. One of my students, who was less than half my age, told me she wanted to kiss me. She said this in a very public place, while I was chatting with her and her best friend. After she said it, I just kept jabbering away about whatever while my brain went, wait, what? We went for a walk and while talking he grabbed my boob. I think I was 11 and he was 14, or somewhere around those ages. It didn't really end as he probably thought it would because I kicked him in the balls and ran. This seems like it would either be hilarious or really creepy to see happen. 10/10. In middle school, a friend of mine was given a love note by a boy with a learning disability that his mom helped him write. He got the teacher to let him stand up and read it to her in front of the class. She was mortified. Maybe in high school everyone would have been mature enough to be understanding of that, but not in middle school. It's like some adults were never children. A guy in my class followed me out after an exam and, because of previous encounters, I went into another building to get away from him. When I came out 10 minutes later thinking the coast was clear, I started walking again, looked up ahead and he was staring at me. I looked away and kept walking, only to realize he was hiding behind a tree waiting for me to catch up to him. He then came out from behind the tree, didn't say anything to me but walked next to me, and then followed me into another building to ask if he could walk with me. He then asked me out and I declined. A coworker purchased a $3,000 giant lizard. I think a monitor lizard. He mentioned he named it my name. I laughed, not getting it, and asked if it's spelled the same. He looked at me super intensely and said, yes, exactly like you. I was only 19, and I sort of just walked away. I was in a study abroad program in college with about 55 students. It's a small house. People talk. This dude had been telling people that we dated for 6 months, but that we'd just broken up so they shouldn't say anything to me because I was still heartbroken. As if that would not have gotten back to me. And one of my housemates was my roommate the year before, during the window where he and I were dating, so she knew he was lying. I called him out on the lies, and he actually had the balls to tell me that he had feelings for me, and that talking about us dating was the closest he thought he'd ever get to actually dating me. What the heck? I guess he was right in the end. Some girl that sat at my science table in 8th grade had an Instagram account where she rambled about me and my friends. I had rarely talked to her yet she knew all of my likes and dislikes. She also had her friends talk to me and ask me about my plans all the time and what I did over the weekend and stuff like that. Classic psycho music plays. So, when I was in middle school, I was well known for liking cats. So, some friend of the guy that I actually did like decides that he was gonna follow me around the playground, purring to woo me. A decade later and that still gives me the heebie-jeebies. Not me but a friend. The friend in question is a junior. Apparently he was talking to some friends in class and some random girl, who apparently had a stalker level crush on him for 2-3 years, gave him a box and asked him to hold it. He is pretty nice so he held onto it for her. When he gives it back she opens the box, sees the ring she puts in there, and starts trying to act like he proposed. There is fan fiction starring me. Erotic friend fiction. Guy I've known in passing for a few years invited me to hang out with him, his roommate I was better friends with, and roommate's girlfriend. I got sick and he drove me home where he then spent the hour drive confessing that he had been in love with me for years. We had spoken maybe 24 words in that time, and was pushed to action when he heard my boyfriend was going to propose soon. I don't know what his plan was. Like he thought I'd break up with my boyfriend of 3 years. I tried staying friends but he made it weird, which is sad. He was a pretty cool guy but did not understand boundaries at all. The Jim Halpert maneuver rarely works in real life. When I worked at Home Depot, this woman sack tapped me as we walked past each other in the break room. I was hunched over and asked WTF. She said she was flirting with me. I was 19. She was 27 and married with 2 kids. Sack tapping is a slang term for a form of bullying practiced by some adolescents as a game where a male or female participant attacks by slapping, tapping, punching, kicking, elbowing, twisting, or backhanding a male victim's testicles. For anyone who needs it. He stole my undies. They were sexy underwear my roommate bought for me from her department store job, for whatever reason, but I never wore them. Anyway, one day I was at work and she let her shithead ex-boyfriend and his best friend into our apartment and the best friend went into my bedroom and stole the panties. When I confronted my roommate about letting him into my bedroom when I wasn't home, she didn't see anything wrong with what happened. He also crawled into my bed while I was trying to sleep, but I made him get out of my bedroom. Nobody else in the apartment saw anything wrong with that either. I wasn't even mean about it. Just like I can't let you sleep here. I can't sleep with you in here. Sorry, because I didn't want to look like a bee again. Everyone was pretty much like, why are you being so uptight? His back hurt sleeping on the couch. I actually stood there wondering if I was overreacting because of how much flack these people were giving me about everything that was happening. Anyway, that was a roommate from Hex story 2. I was 18 and very naive at the time this stuff happened. I didn't know how to handle the situation and I was very passive scaredy cat type person who didn't like confrontation. I also knew my roommate from high school and she was a very sweet person who I hung out with enough that I felt comfortable getting an apartment with her. What I didn't know is that she did drugs with the ex-boyfriend and I think it really messed her up. My roommate bought the panties because I was a virgin and didn't have sexy stuff, so she was trying to help me be cool, I guess. I don't know, but I accepted them when she gave them to me and put them in a drawer knowing I'd never wear them. She and her ex-boyfriend seemed to be on a mission to get me to lose my virginity, even though I told my roommate I was waiting for my true love and that the best friend was not him. Her ex-boyfriend would also leave pee in my bedroom, like magazines of naked men, saying that I needed them. The whole situation exploded when my roommate accused her ex-boyfriend of raping her while I was at work. She also tried to kiss me after this happened, so it's possible she did have a weird crush on me, but that's a story for another day. WTF. At the beginning of this school year, there was a girl that I wanted to ask out, but I didn't know her super well, so I decided to ask one of our mutual friends for her opinion on it. I went up to her and said, "Hey, I was wanting to ask you something," and her face immediately lit up, and I realized that I may have made a mistake. I mentioned that I was thinking of asking the other girl out, and my friend immediately got super quiet, which never happens with her, and just said, "Oh, yeah, she's really pretty." I felt so bad, and I couldn't talk to her for like a week because of it. But her and I have gotten closer since then, and are actually going on a date next week, so I guess it didn't end up being terrible in the long run. Get back to me on that date. I'm now emotionally invested in your friend and your girlfriend. He drove a bunch of people home, including me, from a get-together, and he went past my house twice to take other people home first. Then he parked 2 streets away from my house and locked the doors, and started ranting about how women don't appreciate what's right in front of them. It was really freaking scary TBH. "Well, I guess it's your fault for not appreciating the potential rapist right in front of you. I hope he left you alone after that." When I was 13, this kid that was friends with my younger brother and sister used to creepy stare at me when we'd go over his house to hang out. He thought he was smooth for some reason and would try to put his arms around my shoulders and sit real close to me or try some other equally awkward move he probably saw on Saved by the Bell or something. All I remember him for is being the chubby kid who laid on the floor and stuck his butt under the bed for no reason. When I asked why he was just like to fart, like, "What other reason did you think, girl? Makes total sense." Of course, 4 years later puberty hit and suddenly he was a total babe, and then I became the creepy awkward one because he was that attractive. Fun times. No amount of looks can change the fact that he farted under his bed. This girl in middle school gave me flowers and said she liked me, and I didn't know her name. We didn't share any classes. She was really quiet, and those were the first words we'd ever spoken to each other. I didn't know what to say. "You didn't talk about the part where you two got married." Oh man, I've never had a legitimate reason to tell this story. In preschool there was a girl that had a crush on me and desperately wanted to give me a kiss. Naturally at that time girls had cooties and there was no way in heck I was letting that kiss happen. She chased me to the playground at school while I was on the swings. The metal swing hit her in the head and cracked open her skull. She went to the ER and was fine, but I never saw her again. At my 16th birthday party, one of my best friends of like 2 years at the time was planning to ask me out. All of my other friends knew and they were acting really weird throughout the party because of it, trying to get me and him alone, asking me questions about whether I liked him, other dumb teenager stuff. He ended up awkwardly saying, "So, you're a human, I'm a human, let's just be humans together." He tiptoed around the topic for a good 5 minutes before I understood. We ended up not dating, but we're still close and we now joke about this all the time. Late to the game here, but I have a decent one. Someone I'd been friends with for years called me and informed me that their therapist told them to make the call to inform me they had romantic feelings for me. They thanked me for listening and hung up. I had terrible self-esteem and never saw myself as the kind of person someone would want to date. My shock surprise probably made the whole experience much worse. I was once the creep, but not intentionally. The guy I liked now likes me back. Now I can't even look in his general direction without being mad at myself for being such a weirdo to him 6 years ago. I'd write so many notes, draw us together, write stories, at least I didn't show those, thank God. And continued even after I saw that he was visibly uncomfortable. Every time I think about it, I feel the need for memory bleach. Sorry, Ted lol, I really meant it all innocently. That reminds me of too many times where I was kind of a creep. Those teenage hormones make us do some fairly embarrassing stuff. It was senior year of high school. I was passing out invitations for my graduation party to the people at my lunch table when a friend of mine asked me what I thought of another person. We'll call that person Rick. Apparently, Rick was telling my friend that he had a crush on me, I'm a straight guy, and wanted my friend to bring him as a guest to my graduation party. Now, I'm a pretty liberal person, so I had no problems with the fact that Rick was gay, but I really was not comfortable with him being at my party, so I told my friend to tell him no for me. Fast forward to my grad party, everything was going smoothly, but then freaking Rick walks in. He signs his name on the sheet where you write tips or messages to the graduate and then makes his way over to where I'm having a conversation with the same friend from earlier in the story. Rick awkwardly interrupts my friend and steers the conversation to how he never got an invite. Now, I had never gone out of my way to talk to Rick ever in my life, so I'm not quite sure why he thought he was going to get an invite anyway, but whatever. After a few painful minutes of discussion on crappy topics, he just blurts out, "So, I heard you were gay and was wondering if you wanted to go out sometime." This is where it got super uncomfortable, as if it wasn't that way already. Me, "Oh, I'm actually not gay. Sorry, but I'm straight." Rick, "No, you're gay. I know you're gay." Me, noticeably pee off, "Not at all actually. Why would you come here and try to argue with me that I'm gay? That's not for you to decide." I had never been more embarrassed in my life and I still cringe about it sometimes. "Bro, I'm pretty sure you're gay." In college, one of my good friends called me at 2 a.m. It took about 2 seconds for me to realize he was drunk, as he was slurring his words pretty badly. "I have something to tell you." "Okay, shoot. I have feelings for you." I had no idea, but didn't return his feelings, so all I could stutter out at that point was, "Okay." There was an awkward silence, but the conversation moved on to other things as drunk conversations tend to do. 10 minutes later, "I have something to tell you." "Okay, I have feelings for you." Turns out, he was blacking out and didn't remember telling me the first time, or the second time. I eventually ended the conversation so we wouldn't have to dance through the awkwardness a third time. Never talked about it again after that. To this day I have no idea if he remembers telling me. The situation wasn't really creepy so much as I dodge wasn't interested in a bullet. This punk chick gave me her number when I was working at a video store. I didn't call cause I am not into the punk look. A coworker knew her and told me later that she was crazy and set fire to her parents' house. Miss me with that arson crap. I was a teenage guy, hanging out with teenage guy friends. 6-year-old sister of one of the teenage guy friends comes out and during a conversation lull, in front of everyone puts her hand on mine and says, "Will you be my boyfriend?" So anyway, I died from embarrassment and 9 years later I'm a Reddit browsing ghost. That's actually cute. I'm sure she's so embarrassed now as a teenager. I was asking him for advice on how to talk to my crush and he basically blurted out, "I had a crush on you in 8th grade in a very I still have a crush on you way." So not a good person to get advice about talking to a crush from. Okay, so there was this one guy I went to a theater program with on the outskirts of town way back in the day, and I guess he had a bit of a crush on me because he friended me on Facebook and then told me in a message a couple of weeks later. The problem was not with the manner in which he told me, but with the fact that at the time, he was 16 years old, and I was 12. Naive as I was back then, even 7th grade me had the sense to notice that this was a giant red flag. Yes, he turned out to be a total creep a couple of years later. When he showed up at my apartment and forced me into his car at midnight to take me to get ice cream, realized then he may have thought it was a bit more than a friendship. In 9th grade drama class, this girl asked the teacher to keep me after class to help her practice a scene. Turned out she was doing a Juliet monologue and I was standing in for Romeo. The teacher sat me down on a chair in the center of the room and stepped back. Then this girl dramatically walks through the door from the teacher's office where she had been hiding and stands like 5 feet in front of me. She stared into my eyes for the entire thing, professing her love to Romeo, while my drama teacher giggled over in the corner. I was 100% not into this girl, but as I awkwardly left after the bizarre situation was over, my teacher said you two would be so cute together. Nope, 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 nope. To be fair, that does sound adorable, especially from the perspective of a teacher watching her students. Stalking me when I was 15. He was a few years older. He always turned up to get the same bus as me after school without fail. I used to go out after school with friends so he had no way of knowing what time I would get the final bus home without following me. Then he would walk me home despite living the opposite direction when we get off the bus and me insisting he shouldn't. Final nail in the coffin was delivering a girlfriend Valentine's card and chocolate to my house which was taken in by my confused dad. I was so upset and embarrassed I screamed at the boy the next time I saw him and he left me alone. I'm sorry Esmeralda, I didn't mean to. I was the hopeless romantic to a teacher in my school and oh my word I cringe so hard when I think about it. WTF was wrong with me? I've only been a teacher for 2 months now and I've found some uncomfortable doodles of me on students' papers. And had one girl start asking if I had a girlfriend. It's not ideal. This girl from senior year of college bought a video game for us to play together and kept insisting on making me dinner. Took me longer than it should have to figure it out. It wasn't all bad. In fact, there was a moment when I thought about hooking up with Charlotte, but it was a small thought. Soon after she started reaching out, asking to hang out, I didn't mind and I made the time. She bought Diablo 3 for us to play together, and I enjoyed that time. But in the process I realized that I wasn't interested in her, and never would be. I started to pick up that she was interested, but didn't react right away. Up until this point she didn't do anything creepy, but it got kinda weird after this. It started when she asked me for advice. She came to my room, dorm, and told me that she had a date that night but wanted to cancel because she liked someone else. It was pretty obvious that the someone else was me. I don't even remember the advice I gave because it was clear what she was going to do. But you have to realize she still hadn't told me, and said anything to me about liking me. At this point I probably should have sat her down and talked to her, but I was in a pretty bad place myself and basically ghosted her. As much as you can ghost someone in a dorm of 300 people. She didn't get the hint, and continued to come talk to me. I was always cordial. She then proceeded to make a school event much less enjoyable by getting ridiculously drunk both nights when she was supposed to be DD. But that's another story. TLDR. Girl bought video game to play with me. Things didn't end well. Oh, that sounds absolutely amazing. If you are new to the channel, you can subscribe. I publish new videos every day. Until then, check another video. Bye for now.